Hello everybody and welcome to the channel. My name is Plummy and in this video I'm gonna continue my reaction to NCT 127's recent album Neo Zone. In this video I'm gonna be checking out the songs Mad Dog, Sit Down, Love Me Now and Love Song. After checking out the first four songs of the album, excluding the title track which I already reacted to, I'm kind of disappointed so far with the first four. I mean, I kind of knew that the songs were going to be exactly that because I've listened to maybe a tiny bit, like I've definitely glossed over their B-sides, but I never really listened to them. And just by other people's opinion that I've heard, I've known that their B-sides have been very much your average K-pop song, which is not necessarily a bad thing, but like with the kind of music that NCT does, I expected, or at least I wished, there was going to be something more interesting, at least for me, in the B-sides, but there wasn't, at least in the first four, so hopefully, if not in even in this one, there will be in the last one. But yeah, I guess without further ado, let's get into the reaction, starting with Mad Dog in 3, 2, 1. Okay, so this is a subunit, I guess. Of a subunit. This is NCTception. Okay, I'm clearly hearing Mark in the background, so why isn't he marked in the video? Huh. I'm really curious what people think about this song. I might have to listen to it a second time because it's one of those noise songs which I love usually. We go hard, but chill them, may they drop it, let it go. Pop it, let it show. Jigum sok do ramen, I'm a good to sack the gong. I said drop it, let it go. Pop it, let it show. We blow with the bass, shot this top for man a dog. Unfortunately, this sound is so annoying. Oh my god, like, it, I can see people really hating this one. Okay, this song completely switched to something completely different. Honestly, I'm kind of fascinated by this one. I don't know if I love it, but I'm definitely interested. Please don't use autotune. I feel like this is what I wanted BTS's to be. And I feel like they maybe tried to do that like that, but I don't know. Honestly, I'm really starting to love this sound. Okay, I'm not gonna react to it again for two reasons, those being because I have to record quite a lot of videos after this one, and two, I'm a bit tired, so it's gonna be a bit repetitive, but I feel like this one definitely has the potential for me to really like it, because it's one of those songs that sounds either annoying or like a complete mess when you listen to it for the first time, but the more you listen to it, the more you love it. Like, already by the third time we heard that kind of obnoxious sound in the song, I started to like it. So I think after a few more listens, I'm definitely gonna like this one. And as I said, I compared it a little to BTS's which is from their recent album. I feel like it's kind of similar because also trying to be kind of annoying to you, but then supposedly would get better. And I'd say I've definitely kind of grown, it has grown on me, but I feel like definitely like this one much more than that. So even based on the fact that I still am not all over this song, I'm definitely gonna give it at least a 9.3 out of 10, because the fact that I kind of started to like it already means that I'm probably gonna fall in love with it. But this one is clearly gonna be a very divisive song, so objectively I'm gonna give it only a 9 out of 10. But yeah, let's get into the next song of this video, that being Sit Down, in 3, 2, 1. Yeah, okay. Yeah. I got a bad habit. Wait. I've heard this beat. This is literally G Idol's Dollar. I'm never gonna forget now. I'm gonna constantly compare this. But so far it definitely seems like I'm liking this part of the album more, because I'm already kind of liking this one. Okay, this is the NCT I love. I'm just not gonna get over the fact that this sounds so much like that. I mean, it doesn't even sound like it. It's literally the same sound they're using. I mean, I don't care. I'm not gonna scream plagiarism or anything. I don't like the slower parts of the song, definitely, but when it goes on the hard-hitting rap part, I definitely like it. What's with NCT songs and switching, like, I mean, I guess that's kind of a quality thing. That's like part of NCT songs, to have like three songs shoved together. But like sometimes it's really jarring on first listen. This part of the chorus is really catchy. Honestly, I wish more of the song was just this kind of, I guess, trap beat would be a good thing to call it. And kind of just don't do the vocal parts. Maybe this should have been another subunit song, I don't know. But yeah, I kind of like this one, I guess. The rapping is pretty good. The singing, kind of don't care about it. It's fine, like it's not bad by any means, but I don't think it really even brings down the quality of the song. So overall, I'd say I like this one, but I feel like it just would have been better if it was just completely focused on the rapping, like just like the last one. I think if it tried to do the same thing with like a subunit, it would have been better rather than trying to do it with the whole group. And again, I forgot to give ratings for the... So for this one, personally, I'm gonna give it an 8.1 out of 10. I'm gonna give it an 8.5 out of 10, because as I said, I definitely enjoy it. The trap beat part of it and the rapping, I really like. The singing could have done without, but it's still fine the way it is. Like, there's not much to complain. Objectively, it's also going to be an 8.5 out of 10, because I don't think people would really disagree with my opinion. So let's move on to the next song of this video, that being Love Me Now, in 3, 2, 1. Okay, I'm liking how this one is building up. Please don't be a letdown. Okay, this one sounds like a 10 out of 10, but I don't know. The lyrics so far are not catchy. They don't even rhyme. Which is kind of annoying me. But definitely sound really good. Like, this sounds like such a good song. I think on the sound alone, I'm ready to give it like an 8.5. You know what? I think I'm gonna give this one a 10 out of 10, because I'm kind of liking it. Probably would be better and more coherent on a second listen, but we don't get that right now. I think this might be the best song so far. Honestly, the difference between the first four songs and these four is like a night and day to me. Yeah, I feel like after, like, on a second listen, the weird, not really rhyming lyrics, which kind of don't go with the beat at all, would feel better. Because right now, they are conflicting with the beat, and it doesn't sound as satisfying. Okay, I definitely like this one. I wish the beat was a bit more pronounced, but it's still fine. Yeah, sadly I don't have the time to react to it one more time. But I really hope, like, in following listens, it was the weird non-rhyming lyrics would not be as bothersome. Because that's the big thing about this song that I don't like. Because otherwise it sounds like such a good song. also, it has some elements of American music, like it sounds a tad bit like it, but it's a minor thing. Okay, so for this one, I like it. I really like it. I think this might be my favorite out of the B-side so far, and it probably is gonna stay my favorite. I think I might even like it more than the title track, but I'm not sure about that. But yeah, definitely feels instantly like a 10 out of 10, so I honestly want to give it that, but as I said, those non-rhyming lyrics are really grating. Like, I want them to sound a certain way to satisfy me, but it doesn't go in that way, and it kind of goes against that. It doesn't make me feel satisfied. And so, because of that, I'm only gonna give it a 9.8 out of 10, which is still, like, might as well be a 10 out of 10, but I just want to kind of show that there's something that could be made better, or it will get better just by listening to it. But yeah, objectively, I'd say it's a 10 out of 10. Like, if you don't care about the way the lyrics sound, you probably enjoy this song, because it just sounds like a good song. Like, there isn't anything I can nitpick about it. Like, it sounds good. What more do you need from a song, really? So yeah, let's get into the last song of this video, that being Love Song, in 3, 2, 1. I love Haechan's voice. Honestly, he's my favorite vocalist in NCT. Honestly, I've never noticed or paid attention to Yuta's voice, but damn, it doesn't match his face at all. So I feel like they should have swapped this one with the first song that I checked out in the last video, because this one feels more like the other three songs from the last video, both in terms of the actual song and in the quality. Obviously, this one is more focused on the singing, which, I mean, to say that I don't like it, it's a bit harsh, but like, I just enjoy rapping more. Still, it doesn't sound bad. The singing is great, especially Haechan. I think he's objectively the best vocalist in... I mean, it might be wrong to say objectively, but he's, to me, the best singer in NCT. I'm sorry, I'm not speaking a lot for this one. There just isn't that much to talk about. So I kind of expected that the last one of this video wasn't going to be as good as the other three, because I kind of like all three of them. Because in the last video, if you watched it, you would have seen that I liked the first one but didn't like the following three songs, so this one kind of is the opposite. But yeah, this one again wasn't bad. Definitely High Chan shined the most in this one, at least in my opinion. Paid attention to him the most. But for the rest, I really don't care. It doesn't feel particularly memorable. The singing is not bad, obviously. But like, there wasn't much in the song that stands out for me or that would make me listen to it because it's unique or anything like that. So personally, I'm gonna give this one a 7.8 out of 10, which is still a pretty good score. While objectively, I'm going to give it an 8.4 out of 10, which is a bit more because I assume most people would enjoy them. I don't know how exactly NCT fans and citizens feel about NCT's B-sides, because as I said, I haven't really listened to NCT B-sides. This is like my first time really getting into them, because I'm mainly a fan of NCT because of their title track sound, and obviously their B-sides are different. So yeah, I don't know exactly how I feel about them. I definitely enjoy overall these four songs more than the last four, but mainly it's because of the first three songs of this video. So yeah, I think we have three more songs from Diablo to check out, which is gonna be in the next video. But yeah, if you guys have any requests for K-pop songs you want me to react to, make sure to comment them down below and I'm gonna add them to my list, though I don't promise when and if I'm definitely going to check out your request, but so far I think I've checked out most of the requests. It just takes a while because I have a lot of requests, and especially when there are a lot of comebacks. And now especially because I want to check out albums and EPs and mini albums and everything, it takes me quite a lot of time to get through all that. So it's probably going to be a while until I get to your specific request, but make sure to comment down below and I'm going to do my best. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like, subscribe. Also, check out the list in the description to my Twitter if you want to follow me there, and to my Wattpad where I post my stories, because in addition to doing all these videos on my channel, I'm also a writer. And in addition to being a writer, I also frequently review my favorite TV shows, movies, video games, anime, cartoons, like anything like that that you can think of. And even sometimes we'll be doing some K-pop related posts that I don't really feel like doing a video for them. So if you're interested in that, check out my blog, it's linked in the description. And if you end up enjoying my blog posts, you end up enjoying my stories, or simply enjoy my videos, you can head over to Patreon or Subscribestar, where you can pledge your support and help keep the channel going, help support me so I can do all that shit. And additionally, you'll be supporting me in a very special way, because if you watch my videos for a while, you might have noticed that I'm trans, but the thing is, I'm not sure exactly whether I'm specifically male to female or just non-binary, but I'm definitely not simply male, I think that's for sure. So with your help, I will be able to transition and figure that shit out. So if you can spare any amount and donate on Patreon or Subscribestar, that would be greatly appreciated. But I still don't want to guilt trip you into doing it, so if you don't want to, that's completely fine. You can still help me out by liking this video, subscribing, and especially sharing this video with somebody who you think might enjoy it. And I think that's pretty much it for this video, so hopefully I'm gonna see you in the next one. Bye!